Hello, everyone. Happy Tuesday. Welcome to Virtual Club Live. Hope you've had an amazing week so far, and thanks for joining us today. I'm Josh Peterson. We're broadcasting here live from the Boys and Girls Club Music and Arts Center in the beautiful, the very hot downtown Kennewick, Washington. We've got a great show coming up today on Virtual Club Live. So many activities today. It's a hot day today, as we know, and Walter here is going to show us how to make a summer refreshing drink, hibiscus tea, agua de Jamaica. Super looking forward to this great video. Also, sports fans, we got our first sports video today. John breaking down some basketball dribbling basics. Plus, art projects with Jesse showing us how to make a beaded wind chime. Plus, Jesse is here in the studio today doing a drag painting project. Also live in the studio, Nathan is here with a great music performance. Really looking forward to seeing and hearing that. Also, this week's virtual club challenge, the new one, portrait photography. Excited to announce that as we get our new week going. But first, we want to give a big shout out to all the great preschoolers in our community, especially the ones at the Club Discovery preschool over in Pasco at the Main Branch Clubhouse there, enjoying some water fun at the end of last week. It's going to be a really, really hot week this week, but they know how to beat the heat. Got the sprinklers on, playing with water balloons and lots of water fun. We really appreciate them hanging out and beating the summer heat in some summer style. If you are a little hot right now, it's going to be warm. We got 100 degrees today, 105, I think, and then 110 later on this week. We got a way for you to beat the heat if you don't want to run around in the sprinklers. Walter is here. He's going to show you how to make a great summer drink called hibiscus tea or agua de Jamaica. Check it out.
Hey, Walter here. Today we're going to show you how to make a refreshing drink called agua de Jamaica or hibiscus tea. And this is what we need to make our drink. We're going to need a strainer, a large bowl, pitcher. We're going to need some hibiscus flour, sugar, a large spoon, cutting board, oranges or lime to garnish. And also we're going to need water. All right, let's make our drink. So first thing we're gonna need boiling water. I have about 3 cups of boiling water here. I pour the flour in here. Let it sit for a little bit. And now it's hot, you have to let it sit to cool down a little bit. So now it's ready to drink. Salute. It's delicious, very refreshing. Enjoy your summer and let us know if you make this drink.
All right, thanks for that great video, Walter. We super appreciate your drink making skills. When we shot this video, Walter let us drink some of the hibiscus tea. It was absolutely delicious, very refreshing, kind of cranberry-y, but a very, very good drink. Perfect drink to make today on a hot summer day. If hibiscus tea is not really your jam, don't worry, today, it's National Chocolate Milk Day. Kind of a super different drink, a different beverage to go down, but I gotta tell you, I love my chocolate milk, and whether it's chocolate milk or hibiscus tea, you know, we got you covered here. Lots and lots of great beverages for you to enjoy as the summer really ramps up here and we get into those triple digits. But right now, we're gonna be refreshed with some amazing art. Jesse, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm doing good. How was your weekend?
Very hot.
Yes,
so
very
trying
hot.
To stay cool.
I know. It's just, it like came out of nowhere. Well, I don't know if it came out of nowhere, but yeah, we're in summer now, officially.
Oh,
it's
definitely
super hot. Yeah. Well, it's art project time. What are we gonna be doing today?
So we are gonna be doing drag or scrape painting, and it's a really cool, fun technique on how to paint using everyday objects.
Very, very cool. All right, well, I hope you're ready at home, because let's get ready for some art with Jesse.
Hi everybody, I hope you enjoyed this project today. I'm gonna show you how to create some really cool painting artwork using everyday objects as your brushes. So I'm gonna start out with a couple different colors. My first colors are gonna be green, and I'm gonna use two different colors, a dark and a light. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm using cardstock paper. You can use canvas, cardstock paper, a thick watercolor paper also. Plain paper really doesn't work because it will warp and rip. So you definitely want something a little heavier. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna take my colors and squirt on the bottom of my paper. I'm gonna give it a little dollop. And I'm leaving space in between my light green so that I can put my dark green in. All right, so my very first object I'm gonna use is a simple comb. All right, make sure this is not like your older sister's comb that she uses for her hair. Make sure it's a comb that you can either throw away afterwards or you can always keep in your art supplies. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take it, I'm gonna stick it right into this paint, and I'm gonna drag up, giving it a little bit of a wavy look. Now, depending on how much paint you originally put on will depend on how tall you can go. And then if you want, you can even press harder and make lines through it to maybe represent grass. All right. Next, I'm gonna use this backside of my comb, press down really hard, and I'm gonna make some extra lines. If you need to add more paint to your picture at any point in time, feel free. All right, so I've got a couple lines here that are gonna make really great stems. Now, for this next part, I'm gonna use my fingers. So I'm just gonna take a finger, grab a little bit of yellow to create the center of my flowers, and just dab it right on it. All right, so I've got four flowers going. Now I need petals. Again, using fingers, depending on how big you want your petals to be, you can just dab it right on in. All right, and then my last step is I'm gonna add a little bit of leaves to our flowers. So I'm just gonna take our light colored green, put a little bit in my palette, just like that. I'm going to use a plastic spoon. Just go ahead, coat the back of it, just like that. Figure out where I want my leaf to start, press and pull out. And you may have to do this a couple times to get the leaf shape that you want. All right. Almost done. Just gonna add in two more leaves to my flowers. All right. And that's it. Super fun, super simple, and it's a great way to paint if you do not have paintbrushes at home. You can use pretty much anything you want at home to be able to do your scrape and drag painting.
It's an awesome, awesome project. I'm just impressed at how it looks so beautiful and so colorful in just a short amount of time, so this is amazing.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. And like I said, you can get really creative on the different things that you use to drag through.
Right on. Very cool. Jesse, thank you so much for being here. We love having you. Thank you.
It's a blast. Thanks.
If you can't get enough art projects or enough Jesse, we got another video coming up right now. This is the beaded wind chime video from Jesse. Check it out.
Hi everybody, it's Jesse, and I wanted to show you how to make a really fun project that you can hang up outdoor and just make it a little colorful. So today what you're gonna need is you're gonna need a stick from outside, some string, and some really fun beads. Now the beads can be whatever colors you guys have at home or what you want, all right? Totally up to you. So the first thing we're gonna do is we are gonna go ahead and we're gonna cut our string. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna keep that doubled and I'm gonna come to my stick with that loop, figure out which side of my stick I want up, and I'm gonna take that loop just like that, and then I'm going to go ahead and pull the string through that loop around the stick and pull it tight. All right, and that attaches your string to your stick. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and start beading. So you're gonna probably add anywhere between 8 to 10 beads on each string. You can do whatever color pattern you like, whatever colors. You can make it completely crazy and not even have a pattern at all. All right, so let's get going. All right, when it comes to the last bead of your string, you're actually going to knot it with that bead. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put the bead right in the middle, loop it with my fingers, just like that, and pull good and tight because you don't want the beads to fall off. So make sure you pull it good and tight. And sometimes it helps if you do a second knot, just like that. All right, so that's what my first string is gonna look like. Now I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna work on the second string. All right, see how it's coming? And it's perfectly fine if your strings are, you know, maybe different lengths, different sizes, okay? And so I'm just gonna go ahead and cut another strip. All right, once you've got all your beads on, it's gonna look amazing, okay? And then the last thing we need to do is we need to add the string so it can hang. So go ahead, cut off another good chunk of string. Okay. And then you're gonna go ahead and you're gonna tie on one end of your stick, and you're gonna wanna double knot this so that it's good and tight. All right, mine is all secure. So now you can go ahead and you can take your really awesome project and you can hang it up outside, off your door, out of a tree, wherever you guys want. It could even hang up in your room. I would love to see all your guys' amazing creations. So make sure that you post it, post a photo down below so I can see how awesome you guys are. All right, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.
All right, thanks Jesse for another amazing art project. A great way to add some color inside or outside of the house. appreciate all that great artistic creativity, and we would love to see you guys make these art projects at home and send them over to us so we can get a look at all the amazing work that you're doing at home. If you are interested in taking some art classes, we've got a great one coming up this Thursday. It's a free class that we're holding through Zoom. It's a collage art class. We're gonna learn how to make a colorful fish with some pieces of scrap paper, colored paper, newspaper, some cardboard, and a few other items. 11 a.m. and 3 p.m. It's the same class both times, so you can pick the time that works best for your schedule. Class is gonna be about 45 minutes, and it's geared toward elementary school kids. You can register at tricitiesmac.org or email virtual@greatclubs.org, and we'll send you the Zoom class login information. Again, this class is 100% free. Also, we got another great class that's starting on August 5th. This is actually a 4-week virtual course all about watercolor painting. Doing this for 4 Wednesdays in August, starting on the 5th. The cost of the class is $40, and that includes all the major materials. Watercolor paper, watercolor paint, paint brushes, oil pastels, and things like that will all be included. Doing 2 sessions, a 10 a.m. for K through 3 grade youth, and then a 12 p.m. for 4th to 7th grade youth. It's about 45 minutes each session. If you're interested in enrolling in this class, you can, again, go to tricitiesmac.org or email virtual@greatclubs.org, and we'll hook you up with all the login information. If you're out and about over the next few days and want to help support Boys and Girls Clubs while doing some artistic purchases, you can head over to Michael's. They are currently running a campaign to raise funds for the Boys and Girls Clubs of America. The cashiers at the register are asking for donations when you check out. Last year, Michael's raised $1.8 million. Incredible. Appreciate them and all of their amazing support. If you don't feel comfortable going into the store, you can go to michaels.com and make an amazing donation there that will support clubs, not just in our community, but across the country. So a big shout out to Michaels and all the artists out there. But all youth, if you're not interested in art, if you want to try something else, we are really excited to do our very first sports video right now. John here is going to show us some basketball basics. This is all about dribbling. Check it out.
Hey guys, John here. Today I'm just gonna be going over basketball basics with you guys. Something really important that you guys wanna remember before you start any type of dribbling is you wanna get your fingertips warmed up and just kinda do some type of warm up to get your muscles moving. Because your fingers, if you're not using them all day, they get kinda stiff. So something I like to do is just kinda going back and forth right here, getting that ball used to being in your hands. And this is something that you would love to do and you would want to do just to kind of get your fingers used to having a ball in your hands. You can even go up here with it a little bit, get it going quicker, get the taps going. So something else I'll do after I get done doing this is I kind of just want to go back and forth here, getting my hands moving a little bit, moving those hands with the ball, cradling it back and forth. So it's just one motion. Then you want to go backwards, go back with it, nice and smooth, not rushing it. If you lose the ball, that's okay. You want to kind of go slow just to get in rhythm, get your arms moving. Then you also, it's very important to switch hands. So switching hands, going with the opposite hand. Next thing I'm going to show you is just basically how to do right-handed dribbling. So feet evenly spaced, if you're standing in place, your butt down, your back straight. So you're not leaning over. You're just going like this. You can do low dribbles with it. Bring it up a little bit once you're doing low dribbles for a little bit. And then really pound that basketball, getting your arms moving. And then like I said, real important, you switch hands. So now I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna do a little bit of my left hand. Next thing, I'm gonna show you how to do a basic crossover. So again, it's real important that when you're doing these moves, you're staying in a nice athletic stance, because a lot of people, they will kind of raise up when they're doing this and they're off balance. So now, again, we're gonna work on the crossover. And so what I like to do is I like to go 1-2 cross, 1-2 cross, 1-2 cross, 1-2 cross. But one thing I want to show you, once you learn the basics, then you can switch it up and get a little bit quicker and do a move like this. Hope you guys enjoyed this video today. We would love to see some videos and some photos of you interacting, trying some of these basic dribbling drills. I'll catch you guys next week.
All right, thanks for that great video, John. Appreciate you and all of your basketball knowledge. That was our very first sports video that we've ever done, and more are on the way, so we're really, really looking forward to that. If you're a sports person, if you want to get into sports, want to get interested in basketball, we've got a basketball sports training class coming up next week. This is Wednesday, August 5th. At 1 p.m., John is going to break down some basketball basics, talking about dribbling and shooting and things like that. This is for kids in grades 2nd to 8th grade. You can register at tricitiesmac.org or email virtual@greatclubs.org, and we'll send you the Zoom class login information. Again, this class is 100% free. You just need a basketball and a little open space to dribble. If you don't have a hoop, it's not a big deal. We can make it happen, and John is really pumped to show you guys some great basketball skills and dribbling techniques. All right, well, coming up next, Nathan is going to be here in the studio. We're going to be doing a great music performance. Super looking forward to that. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back with music from Nathan.
For as long as we've existed, Boys and Girls Clubs has always been about coming together to support the families of our communities and do whatever it takes to give every kid a chance at a great future. But we're going through a challenging time right now. And while we may not all be able to come together in the same physical ways, in other ways, we're coming together like never before. Because that's what whatever it takes to build great futures means. It means providing a safe place to go for children whose parents are on the front lines battling the virus. It means providing millions of meals for kids who previously relied on their school or a meal program, which are now shut down. And it's about harnessing the power of technology to keep kids moving forward with their education. So yeah, whatever it takes to build great futures may mean something different right now. But whatever it is, that's exactly what we're going to keep doing.
All right, we're back with Nathan. Nathan, how are you doing today?
I'm doing so good. It's actually a little early. I'm a little tired, but
yeah. This is our first 10 a.m. show. We used to do 1 p.m.s, and yes, we're switching it up, doing the 10 a.m.s right now. So it's kind of early for everybody. But
yeah, I woke up a little bit earlier than normal just to come here, practice a little bit. And yeah, I'm really feeling it.
Yeah, man. So we got a marimba out in front of us. What are we going to be doing today?
Yeah, so I'm going to be playing, what am I playing?
I don't know.
I know what I'm playing. I just can't remember the
name.
Can't remember the name.
It's okay.
Bolero?
Bolero.
No, not that.
That's for another video.
Oh, sorry.
Name doesn't matter, I guess.
It doesn't matter. It's just the music that matters.
Yeah, I got the name over there, but I guess too far.
That's all good. So what's the piece about, or what are some things that people should look out for while they're watching you play?
Yeah, I guess like the two-hand independence. There's a lot of different things where like my left hand is trying to like do the same like left-right sort of thing, and then my right hand is gonna be doing something over top of it. And so it's really cool to watch like the one hand do its thing that you know it's gonna keep doing, and then the other one is like playing all the melody over top of it.
Right on.
So that's something that's really cool to look out for.
Very cool. All right, well, I'm gonna get out of the way and I'll let you take it away with your piece.
Sweet, thanks.
Thanks, Nathan.
All right, I'll tell you guys the piece now. Josh just showed me. It's Rain Dance. This is a very common marimba piece. It's like one that everyone tends to learn. And it tends to get a little overplayed sometimes, but I'm guessing you guys haven't heard it yet. Here we go. Thank you.
job, Nathan.
Yeah, thank you, thank you.
How'd that one feel?
It felt pretty okay. Yeah, it kind of went as well as I practiced it.
It's all good. It sounded amazing. It sounded really great.
Thank you. So. If you ever like watch someone else play marimba, like the odds of you watching a different piece other than this one is very, very low. This is like a very common one.
This is a super famous one for marimba. Absolutely. Well, thank you for sharing it with us, Nathan. It was absolutely amazing.
Yeah, you're welcome.
If you're interested in learning how to play an instrument, a marimba, drum set, guitar, piano, we are offering virtual music lessons. These are one-on-one lessons happening here in the studio Monday through Thursday for K through 12 kids. The first lesson is free. You can register at tricitiesmac.org. You see Nathan there giving a lesson. Unfortunately, Nathan is no longer going to be doing the virtual lessons. This is Nathan's last week with us. We are so sad. Nathan, what are you going to be doing after this week?
Yeah, so I'm moving to Ellensburg to start school at Central Washington University. I decided to get a head start before school started and make sure I got settled there.
Yes, we're very sad. We're going to miss you, but I'm so excited for what is going to happen next in Nathan Martini's journey. Nathan has been with the club for a very, very long time. Longer than me, many, many, many years. If you haven't known Nathan for a while, we got a great video that we want to share with you that's going to show Nathan from many years ago. Check this out. Man, this was so long ago, Nathan. Does this bring back memories?
Dude, you memed me.
You got memed.
You brought it out of the blue. Like, it was better to let that thing die.
No, man. This thing has almost 2,000 views on YouTube.
Are you serious?
I'm not kidding.
That's kind of cringe. But I didn't even know the lyrics. I was trying to pretend like I knew them.
And you're wearing the same shirt, right?
Yeah. In my defense, these shirts do last quite a while.
Yes, they do. This video took us a long time to shoot, but it was a lot of fun. And so Nathan has been a fixture of the Boys and Girls Club for a very long time. So, yeah.
I've been coming here since I was 10. I started working after a year of leaving, I started working here.
Yeah, right on. Well, we're gonna miss you a ton, Nathan. We appreciate everything that you've done for the club. Everything that you've done to make the organization better. You are absolutely leaving the MAC and the club better than how it was when you first got here. So from all of us here, thank you for everything that you've done. We appreciate you so much.
Yeah, well, I've got to say, even though I've left the club better, the club has left me better. So it's kind of this cycle of it influenced me and I came back and influenced it again. So
that's awesome.
It was honestly the best experience to be a part of the club, and I wouldn't trade it for anything.
Right on. Well, we wish you the best of luck in everything and everything in your future, Nathan.
Yeah, awesome. I'm excited.
Right on. We're going to take a quick break and then we're going to be back with this week's virtual club challenge.
Tricitians, we all want to get back to normal.
It can happen if we do this together.
You and I are the solution. Let's all do our part.
Face coverings help stop the spread of COVID-19.
Wear it when you visit a public place.
Make coverings your public face.
Be insistent on social distance.
Maintain a 6-foot space and wash your hands frequently.
Let's do this. Let's get back to normal.
All right, if you're looking for a mask, we've got a great fundraiser that benefits the Boys and Girls Club right here in Benton Franklin County's Love the Pasco Taco Crawl. You can go to facebook.com/PascoTacoCrawl to get one of these masks. They're $15 and all the proceeds go to the Boys and Girls Club. They've raised almost $1,000 for the local club right now. Absolutely amazing. So if you need a mask and want to support the club, here's a great opportunity for you to get involved. Also, we've got a great community event happening tomorrow. If you're in need of some food, we got a free food distribution event happening tomorrow. Starts at 11 a.m. This is at multiple Ben Franklin Transit stations. That's the Three Rivers Transit Center in Kennewick, the 22nd Avenue Transit Center in Pasco, the Knight Street Transit Center in Richland, and the Stacy Avenue Transit Center in Prosser. The Prosser one starts at 11:15 a.m. So a great opportunity if you are in need of some food to go out there and get some during these times. All right, well, it's time for an update on this week's Virtual Club Challenge. Before we announce the winner of this last week's challenge, let's take a look at the challenge itself. Here's Adrian explaining the worm.
Adrian here again. I'm gonna be showing you another breakdance move today. This is called the worm. Now let me break down the worm. Okay, first thing you're gonna do, you're gonna go into this yoga position. With your legs all the way out, you're gonna be on top of your toes and your back is gonna be arched. When you're right here, you're just going to keep this arch, just like a rocking chair. Go ahead and rock forward. You wanna try to go as high as you can onto your chest. Okay? Now, once you master that and you feel like you got this down, you're gonna go ahead and start pushing up with your hands and kicking up with your feet. So practice right now really low. Kick down. Again, kick down. Until you're ready, then you actually will skip that part. Just start landing on your toes. Continue the worm, okay? Now I'm gonna show you how it's done. Submit your photos and videos online, and I'll see you next time.
All right, we appreciate all the great submissions that we receive, but as always, there can only be one winner, and we got a video from this week's challenge winner. Check it out here. Woo! We're doing the worm backwards here, people. We want to give a big, big shout out again, 2 weeks in a row. To Atharva Gupta, you are this week's Virtual Club Challenge winner. Love the moves here. You have done the worm proud. Adrian is also smiling at you. So great job, Atharva. We appreciate you and your great participation. Thanks to everybody else who submitted videos as well. We had a lot of fun with this challenge. But right now, it's a new week and a new Virtual Club Weekly Challenge. We're talking about portrait photography. Cade explains the challenge in this video. Check it out.
Hey guys, it's Cade. Today, I'm gonna be giving you some tips on portrait photography. Portrait photography deals with photos of people and groups of people. They help capture their personality. Photographers help capture these by using different lighting techniques, choosing different backdrops, and putting them in different poses. Now, if you want to start taking portraits, here are some things to remember. The most important thing is to make sure that the subject or the model is well lit. This means that there is enough light on the subject so we can clearly see who they are. If you take a portrait outside, make sure the sun isn't too bright on your subject, and make sure you stay out of really dark places to where we can't see anything. If you're shooting inside, you can use other lamps and even a phone light to make sure that the person's face is well lit and you can see what's going on. When taking portraits, you almost always want to make sure the eyes are in focus. The eyes are a good connection point from the viewer to the subject. Just like when you're talking to someone face to face, you have good eye-to-eye contact. So as an example, I shot some portraits with my good friend Nathan here in our studio. And I used some light rigs that we already had here, but you can use any source of light at your house or even go outside and use the sun. I put them in different poses, lots of silly ones. You can add any sort of personality in there. You can literally do whatever you want. There are no limits to creativity in portrait photography. We would love to see your portraits. You can send it to our email right here or use this hashtag. That's gonna be it for today. Thanks.
All right, so that is this week's Virtual Club Challenge, portrait photography. Get your phone out and take some pictures with it, or if you got a nice camera, you can take some pictures with that as well, of course. So here's how you can participate. Take a picture, a portrait. Maybe it's a friend, someone you're socially distancing with, a family member at home, brother, sister, mom, dad, grandma, grandpa. Take a picture of them, send that submission, that picture, to virtual@greatclubs.org. The deadline is next Monday, August 3rd at 11:59 p.m. And we're gonna announce the winner Tuesday, a week from today, August 4th at 10 a.m. on our Virtual Club Live show. Really looking forward to seeing all the great portrait photography submissions. So get those camera phones out, snap some pictures, and send them on in. The winner of this week's challenge, you're gonna get a $25 gift card from Dutch Bros. Appreciate them and all of their great support. A great prize for a really, really fun challenge that we can all do. All you need is that camera phone. So we hope you had a lot of fun with us today here at the Virtual Club. Appreciate you being with us at our new day and our new time for our weekly show. To find us and watch videos at any time, you can check us out on Instagram and also on YouTube. Just search Virtual BGC BFC. That's Boys and Girls Clubs of Benton and Franklin Counties. A lot of content up there that you can check out at any time. You can also go to bgca.org or clubexperience.blog to see some great resources that are available to families across the country from our national organization. Appreciate them and all of their incredible support right now. If you want to check out content at any time, go to our main website, which is greatclubs.org/virtualclub. We have more than 80 videos up on our website, external resources, previous Facebook Live broadcasts, and so much more. You can check them out at any time. We hope you have a great rest of your day, a great rest of your week, and we'll see you right here on Facebook Live next Tuesday at 1 p.m. Have a great rest of your day and a great week. Bye.